staff to process grass and lumber, and they built a rocking mill and spruce for the pulpwood. The rocking mill would strip off the bark of the red spruce tree, and then they would take 3 trees a day from spruce that's up there on the mountain down to Cass, where they would drop those trees at a sidetrack, and the C&O train would come and pick up those log cars, and they'd take the log cars 45 miles to Covington, Virginia, where the West Virginia Pulp and Paper built a great big pulp mill. That pulp mill is still in operation today. It's now called Seaquest Aco. If you ever had a notebook, on the front of that notebook it said Mead. That's where it came from. Also, red spruce tree was used for various other things, such as the sap was used in making bubble gum, and red spruce made a really sturdy frame that was also light, but it was also used in constructing some of the early aircraft. In fact, the Washington Wright brothers, Wilbur and Orville Wright, ordered a load of red spruce for the past.
Here. That's full of fruit. Cheap milk salivator.
south of McCann. The next day, you would return to Elvis via the train to get your car. That's a two-day trip. And you could go the other way. You could start in Cass and go to Elkins, stay in Elkins, and come back to Cass. But it's beginning to be a popular thing. Right now, we're currently rebuilding the tracks from Cass to Durbin. And in the next year, or maybe 2 years, I suppose, we should have those tracks completely finished. Once we have the tracks from Durbin and Cass finished, you'll be able to ride from Durbin to Cass, from Cass to Elkins. Trains. I'm pretty excited about it, you can tell.